Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about how to sign up powerbi services without having a work or school email account. Powerbi services is meant for deploying your reports that developed in powerbi desktop so that people can share and collaborate with other users. Those who are having an email account with the company name.com or school email account, they can able to deploy without any issues. They just need to sign up using their account. But those people, those do not have that email account that is having a company name.com. Instead, they have the personal email accounts like Gmail or Yahoo. They are not deploying the reports. They stop with Power BI Desktop. This is very useful for them. Or people, those who don't want to use their office email account, then continue watching. Hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. We have seen this Power BI services and what is Power BI Desktop in our previous videos. And we have also seen in my previous video, there is two flows, that is Power BI Cloud Flow, Power BI On-Premises Flow. Just watch my previous video if you haven't seen in Power BI services playlist. Now, coming back to our topic, without work or school email. What I mean here is, if you have your email like at companyname.com, then it is very easy to sign up in Power BI services. Just to publish while publishing in desktop or sign in option, you can easily do it. For those who do not have it, there is two-step process. Let us see it. Those who are having only personal account like this. Step one is to create Office 365 account and get the Microsoft account created. Then you need to have that first step, whatever email account you had, using that you need to sign up to Power BI services so that you can start using it. Let us see it in demo. Go to Google, you type Office 365 E3. Office 365 E3 trial. Because it is paid version, so you go for trial right now. This is to explore, okay? It is not a permanent solution. I mean to say, you can practice using a trial period. Once you like it, you need to pay. That is the point I want to highlight. So let us go for free trial right now. So let me use my Gmail account. So it looks like a need to create a new account. It says like you don't have any Microsoft account with us. Let's say create it. I use Analytics with Nags and your phone number. You provide your phone number, then company name, Nags. Company size 2 to 4 people. You say I'm from India or any country as you wish. I mean, where are you from? So just click next. So they have to verify your mobile. Provide your verification code. You hear that pop up. I got SMS, so let us type it. Verified, then you provide your name. I provide Analytics with Nags. Check availability, whether it's available. Yes, there you go. You have luckily I got. Then here we need to give our name. Let me give Nagam and password, give some good password. That should be a combination of caps and lowercase, uppercase letters. So just you want some tips and other things, you just press, if you don't want to, just uncheck it. Select partners, they can share, just see it whether you want it or not. Just press sign up. So it will take a while to create your account in Microsoft. So along with this, you can explore 365E3 options like other word, everything. Let's okay. You are all set to go. Save this info. Like you can take this one. Remember your password. Go to setup. So now the step one is like I have set up Office 365 account. And we are in a free version, okay, that you need to remember. Now, and you can use that email and you can deploy it. Let's deploy, try to deploy this report. Let's try to log in using our user app.powerbi.com. So there is an account added, okay, this is the account. So I'll try to log in using that account, Microsoft account. Provide your password. So you want to stay signed in? Yes, let us stay signed in using this account. Basically, now it checks for that user. You need to sign up, okay, in the Power BI. This process is similar to, see, you are using with another Microsoft service already. To finish signing in Power BI, sign in with your existing password. Yeah, you can say sign in. Yeah. We saw in our previous video also. Now using this email, I mean this is like analytics with Nags, this one company name and on microsoft.com, okay, our company thing like that account, the company account it means. Now I don't have any other employees, just skip for now. So if you want, you can add some more people over there once you add it in Office 365 account. If you saw in my previous video using the company account, it asked me some of the few details like name, other things. So now it didn't ask me anything since all the information it is fetching it from Office 365 account that we have created just now in this video. So now you see here, you don't have anything over here, like my workspace is empty. Dashboard, reports, workspace. Let's click on this and let's explore this little bit on my workspace later. Now I hope we have created one Office 365 account. You can go and deploy the report here by changing the username. I logged in using my company account. I can log out and I can use the new account I created here, that is naga.analytics on microsoft.com, and I can deploy it. So let us sign in using new user created. Enter the password. We have now we have signed in using our new account created. Let's try to publish it in our Power BI services. Publish. Yes, save it. So I have only one workspace, that is my workspace. Let's deploy it there. Okay, now you can open it from here or browser. I can open it in browser. Just we will go to browser and then we can try to see that one. Now we are in Power BI browser. As you can see, there is no reports yet. Everything is empty reports. Let me refresh it. So once I refresh it, you will see the reports. And you can also have data sets defined here. So let us launch the report. It will appear in your right hand side pane. There you go. So we have created our Gmail account. I mean, using our Gmail account, we have created on Microsoft account. And using that, we have deployed our report in on premises. I hope you guys like this video and share and subscribe to the channel. Comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.